think what is important when we speak about multi-annual financial framework. And there are two projects, as we know, one proposed by the European Commission, another one by the President of the Council. And comparing those two cuts in the second proposal, the cuts are very remarkable. And they're across all budget headings of the budget. That means less money for agriculture, less money for foreign and security policy, less money for cohesion, and less money for programs like, for instance, Erasmus. So when I compare two projects, the difference is huge. For instance, for agriculture, 25 billion euros less, according to Mr. Rumpuy. For Erasmus program, 9 billion euros less. And I'm thinking about the consequences because before I was elected to the European Parliament, I was dean of the faculty at the university, and I remember very well what Erasmus and they know very well what Erasmus means for our students and our professors. And of course, we should give more money for the programs like this. Now, the situation this year is that the budget of 2012 is already say austerity budget, and the situation now in November is that we the gap we need more money. There is no money in the budget, and the gap is something like 9 billion euros, and there are invoices sent to the European Commission from all over Europe, all European universities asking to pay those invoices, and that is about Erasmus. And European Commission, yesterday the commissioner said to in our political group that there is no money. So, but he said it's we have to fulfill our commitments, and it's about credibility of Europe and European Union. So those invoices will be paid, and he is going to say to the leaders and the prime ministers tomorrow, and the European heads of EU member states governments, that that cash is necessary. So Erasmus program is the only one example, but imagine big infrastructure projects. Usually they last not 1 year, but one, two, three, sometimes even more years. And again, invoices were sent to the European Commission. The deadline was end of October, and there is no money. European Commission does not have money to pay. So the austerity budget was adopted because the philosophy was that each and every year, as far as I remember, since 2004, at the end of the year, the assessment was that we have sometimes 3 billion euros, sometimes 7 billion euros, which were unused. In 2010, in 2011, around 7 billion euros were left. So usually the procedure is according to the rules. This sum of money is distributed, sent back to the member states according to their payments made. And so the European Parliament said, okay, if we need to do this haircut, austerity budget, let's have, smaller budget. But now, at the end of the year, we see that the consequences are already clear, and we have a huge problem. So I don't want to repeat this, and to have European Union, not only EU budget, but European Union as such, in paralysis. Otherwise, all our policies, all our programs, all our strategies will be only, slogans, which are written on the paper. But we won't be able to implement them in real life. And that is what I would like to avoid. So it's better to have a tough fight now regarding the budget, but then to have, more peaceful and more calm life in the coming 8 years until 2020, and to have our goals. If not achieved, 100%, but at least to be very close to them.
So hopefully the economy is going to start becoming better, and it will be more money to spend for the good projects which will keep the European Union running and strong.
I hope so. I don't want to argue against agricultural policy or common agricultural policy or direct payments to the farmers, but I understand that the future of European Union lies somewhere else. And if we speak about the competitiveness of the European Union, so the priority should be slightly different. And we have simply we have to have this in mind.
But Lithuania is kind of quite willing to look at the common agricultural policy. They would like to keep it. Is it the case, or we would like to change it start spending some more money on research and development, on education? What is Lithuania's position on CAP?
I do not know what will be the position of the new government, because we have shift and very remarkable shift, and politicians during the election campaign were promising a lot. So let's see if they will be able to implement what they promised, and if they really know how to do things and what to do, and if they are able to achieve this. But I really wish the best. It's because it's about the people and it's about our country. But my understanding is that for Lithuania, we have to concentrate more or to focus more on high technologies, on smart jobs, on everything what is related to the future. I understand that people want to eat, and agriculture is a traditional style of life for a part of our society. And I fully understand and acknowledge that the agricultural lobby is strong comparing to, other groups in the society. But if we want our young people to stay at home, if we want to stop immigration, so we have to think about this. And when I mentioned Erasmus, that is exactly about young people. When I speak about, for instance, cohesion, structural funds, infrastructure projects, again, that would help them to find jobs at home. And also good salaries. So it depends upon what vision the politician has.